Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Buffalo State College Football here at Coyer Field. The Bengals are going to be taking on the Akron Zips. We are in the final two games of the regular season. In this episode, we need to stop quarterback Cato Nelson of Akron to continue to give our team a chance to win out in this video for a shot to compete for the MAC title championship. If you're excited, make sure you drop a like on this video as well as subscribe for the love of franchise content. That's all we do here. Down to the field and the call from Jack Legion.
Two games left in the regular season, and you know what it is time for, primetime football. Nelson, third and three, fires, and it looks like Buffalo State gets the stop right. No, give him just a second. Joey Shoemaker got handsy like a frat boy at a party, and they go right side. Keandre White sheds a tackle. Another one is down inside the 30 at the 25-yard line. 20 whole yards on the carry. They go right back. Keandre all day, first down and goal after a chunk of 17. Nelson, leave it to him. He finds Andre Williams. I don't know what the hell that thing is, but it doesn't make a difference. Prince and Co. go to work, bunch to the right side, finds Denzel Moss. He's across the 30-yard line. He gets hammered himself, gains 10 yards nonetheless, and Banks looking a little slower today, likely abuse from all the carries he's taken this season. They go right back his way, however, to the stretch to the right side, and he cannot get away from two Zips defenders. Sets up third down and 13. Prince takes a snap, runs out of time, has to let it go, and out of nowhere, the defensive back plucks it out of the air. Turnover for Buffalo State. Akron back to work. Nelson fires to the corner. He says, anything you can do, Tayshaun Prince, I can do better. Hits the throw that he couldn't make, and Tremblay left in the dust. They keep it moving. Split back sets up screen to the right side, and White is all alone like he has corona inside the 30-yard line. Excellent opportunity for Akron. Will they score? Third and goal. Matthew Littlefield says, I don't think so, and drives Nelson into the turf. And you might think this is where the offense gets it together. Prince is dethroned. A loss of 8 sets up 3rd and 20. They're not going to convert that. They give it right back to Akron, and they already have excellent field position as Nelson rolls to his left side, decides to take off, and it pays dividends. Moving forward a few plays later, sets up screen to left side. It isn't there. He decides to run yet again. Second time, and Oliver Rover brings him down before he can get too far. But third time is the charm. Nelson, one more time, why don't you? Races to the outside, and he is in. Akron extends their lead 17-0. The Zips up 17-0. So far, no solution for Nelson. Prince gives it to Banks, however, and they don't have a solution for him either as he gains 8 yards. For as slow as he looks, that's impressive. And Banks a little more nimble. Hey, diddle, diddle. Banks right up the middle. Gains 16 down to the Buffalo State logo on senior night. He's one who they're going to miss as Prince drops back and can't get the pass away. Another sack for Akron. They had 4 on the game. And they get the ball right back, floats to the outside. Williams makes the play with under 2 minutes to go. Akron wants one more score to derail the Bengals' home confidence. Floats it outside to Burkhart inside the 50, 22 yards. They keep it moving, going empty 2x3. Nelson to run and can't escape. Dangerous Dante Randall. To be fair, no one could all season long. Double-digit sacks for him officially. Nelson drops back to throw again, steps up, takes off. And Billy Bob Bobo and Randall set up third down, third and 11. Nelson, everyone's covered, right? No, they forgot about Keandre White underneath. And he has a need for speed to get the first down. Under 30 to go. Nelson drops back, fires to the corner, and Stewart with the dime on time sends Buffalo State into the half with a 24-point deficit. Not looking good on senior night. We'll be back right after this. Well, that half sucked. Let's get back underway. Nelson back to work. Finds Stewart in Buffalo State. Needed a stop. Last half couldn't get it. And so far, it's the same old song and dance as Nelson steps back and goes down. Thankfully, Dante Randall's there, and apparently that's a record. Congratulations, Dante. Not exactly helping the score, however, as Nelson fires quick to Smith, and he is about a yard away, 8 yards. Makes it first down and goal, and of course, right to the fullback. What else do you do when you're 1 yard out? They go up 31-0. Hide your eyes, except for that mascot's beautiful dance moves. The 1-2 step comes easy with a 5-possession lead as Banks takes the carry, sweeps to the right side, breaks the tackle, and has a productive run of 8 yards and a first down. One play later, after a loss of 3, Prince rolls to his right side, escapes, and has nothing but green in front of him, out of bounds inside the 30-yard line. 3rd and 10, this is it. Prince fires to Moss, and he can't make the play. Buffalo State has to haul out the field goal unit from about 45 out. Kinsley testing his range and off the front crossbar. But the insanity continues. Meade checks in for an injured Prince. We need some magic at the moment. Ben Bush for 16. Meade back to work, steps up, fires, finds Hunter Haskins. And he has a first down near the 25-yard line, gain of 18. Prince back in the game to give it to Jeremiah Banks, as he's done all season long inside the 15-yard line. And Prince sends Moss in motion, rolls to his right side, stops on the dime, farves it, and it works out for him as Ben Bush hauls it in. 10-yard touchdown. And a beautiful throw from Prince. Checks back in with the strained pectoral. He is okay, apparently, as Bush gets Buffalo State on the board. 52 seconds left in the game. This one is all but over. They kick it deep to DJ Lee, and Lee cuts to the left side. Hasn't taken one back all season. Can he outrun the last few defenders? Lee inside the 30 and drug down. 72 yards on the return. And a bit more of a bright spot on what was a horrible game. They try to score one more time. Prince drops back, fires, and this helps the scoreboard, but not the outcome, as despite a Hunter Haskins touchdown, Akron zips past the Buffalo State Bengals. 34-14 is your final score, but as you know, stick around because we do have a doubleheader coming out about this game, though. Cato Nelson, absolutely impossible to stop in this game, as Jeremiah Banks quietly had a 100-yard game, but it doesn't change that the passing game stalled out. Nobody could get open. Nobody could make catches. And the defense was on the field for a long, long time, which allowed them to get 8 sacks in this game. We move forward. Buffalo State takes on Ohio in Peden Stadium. BSC thought they could escape the snow, but run into some in Ohio in their last road game of the season. Nathan Rourke has some explosiveness. We better look to contain him in this game. As right off the bat, he gets to work. Read option to the left side. Rourke runs over a man. My goodness. Dropped his entire body into him. Speaking of body, Rufus is really feeling it. Over a minute later, possession continues. Rourke fires the wheel on 3rd and 7. Cameron Odom wide open like a Burger King drive-thru. Gets the first down. 2 plays later, 3rd and 8. Can they get off the field this time? Brown makes the catch, and they are 2 for 2 already on 3rd down. Another 3rd down situation, and you already guessed it. Allison picks up the first inside the 5-yard line. They go right back to him, sweep to the left side, and he finds the end zone. Reservations for 6, and the Bobcats ate the entire clock as the Bengals work with just over a minute remaining in the first quarter. And Prince goes down, which gives the ball right back to Ohio. And excellent containment on Julian Ross. Brandon Springs with the TFL. But as we have learned, it does not matter if you make a good play if you can't get the stop. And it, just like that, Elijah Ball with 24 yards and a first. They can't catch a break going into the second quarter, down 7-0 is Rourke. Play action, as my friend Perrin Crow calls, big cojones. Picks up 16 on the rollout for the first. Just over 5 to go in the half. Ross to the right side, and he is running wild, out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. Rourke trying to stay perfect on 3rd downs, and he finds Cameron Odom for a 3-yard touchdown. Ohio up 14-0, and take advantage of a 3-and-out. Ross sweeps to the left side, but not so fast. Marshawn Colliver lays the wood, drills him into the snow, and gives the Bengals the football right back. Outstanding clutch play, and finally a stop. It only leads to a field goal, but Buffalo State finds themselves on the board nonetheless. In a studio update, Akron showing that they are legit, beating 8-3 Toledo 7-0 in the first quarter. Back to this game, that is the end of the first half. Buffalo State down 3-14 in the final game of the season. Zach Meade back in the game. Two straight appearances in games. Tayshaun Prince's season is over, and the projected quarterback from next year has a chance to lead us to victory. But he goes down, a loss of 12. They have to give the football back already. Under 4 minutes to go in the third quarter, Meade gets the football back. Finds Haskins, and what a touch throw to the slot receiver for 17. Meade has a bunch to the right side. Takes the third down snap and fires wildly out of bounds. Not a good look for Meade. This is why he has not been the starter. 2x3 empty, 4th and 10. Pressure comes, fires, and intercepted a little too late. And when the Bengals needed some magic, Zach Meade could not get it done. And they have a chance to extend their lead. The give to Ross right up the middle, gains 10. Rohr takes the momentum into his own hands, fires downfield, and Ball makes the catch. First down and goal for Ohio. They have no solution as he absolutely torches the cover 2 look. A chance to go up 3 possessions, and they capitalize. Julian Ross breaks an ankle in the backfield and finds his way into the end zone. Meade takes back over. Same bunch look, and they're all over it. Read him like a book. Hagan again takes it all the way inside the 15-yard line. And this game has turned from hopeful to terrible real fast. As what is that green screen doing on my Christian broadcast? It's going to stay there for a while. You'll have to deal with it. Oliver Rover dropped for a loss of 7. I'm definitely going to have to fire an intern. Meade fires downfield, and Haskins goes up and gets it. Snags the cookies from the top shelf. A near perfect play. The only thing ruining it is that pestering green square. Into the fourth quarter, down 21 points. Meade, quick pressure comes, and he goes down for a loss of 10. 4th and 16 for the game. Meade takes the shot downfield and nearly intercepted. Jalen Fox covering Moss like a helicopter parent. And Ohio has the ball back. Great field position as Rourke takes off to the left side, tries to put this game away, and a broken tackle gets them in great field position. A chance to go up by 4 possessions and effectively end any chance of a comeback as Rourke breaks a tackle from Spring, spins off of him, makes it look easy. It is 31-3. Buffalo State ran the clock down with Banks, got them into this position, and he caps off the long drive with a 7-yard touchdown as they at least get into double digits on this game in what has been a very terrible episode for the team. 2 minutes to go. Maxwell checks into the game, and he is denied. Simon Stevens in the backfield, playing in his last game as well, as on 2nd down and 10, he hits Denzel Moss. Meade back to work, 14 yards, looking for a score and some optimism going into season 2, but instead, Meade is taken down. They go no huddle for 4th down and 16, 105 and ticking, way downfield, and Moss couldn't get his foot in bounds. Meade's throw a little too far out of play, and just like that, Rourke and the offense of Ohio get it done. Buffalo State loses their final 4 games of the season after a promising 3-game winning streak. It has been an honor of being on call with you all season long. So many memories. But for the last time this season, we turn it back to FG.
And with that 31-10 win over Buffalo State, Ohio will move to 7-5. We drop to 4-8, which marks losing our 4th straight game to end the season. After winning 3 straight mid-year, would have been nice, but the magic truly ran out in the final 2 games of the year as Akron and Ohio simply look like better teams in today's episode. We would not have won the division over Miami of Ohio anyway, as you could see on the screen there, because they won over us earlier in the year. So we really wouldn't have had a chance there. Jeremiah Banks had an incredible season. We didn't have a 500-yard receiver. I'm not going to go too in-depth over the stats, though Dante Randall with an 11-sack season is quite nice. but I'm not going to go too in-depth over the stats because they will be shown and covered in great detail in a season recap video coming to you guys very soon. I hope you're very excited for that as well. The top four teams in the nation, West Virginia, Texas, Michigan, and Washington, will be competing in the college football playoff. I hope you're excited for that. If you are, make sure you drop a like on this video, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and cannot wait to see more for the love of Dynasty, because Dynasty and Franchise is all we do here, and we can build a winner together. Take care, everybody. I feel you back somehow.